Hi guys, this is my wife's Street Triple 675. I thought I'd just run through a few of the things that my wife's got just to help make touring a bit easier. I know it's not what a lot of people would think of as a natural touring machine, but for a lot of people, especially shorter people, people that want to tour solo, people that want a light bike, a fun bike, but can still tour, it's not such a daft idea having one of these. I mean, it's terrific fun to ride. I ride it, but I'm just too big for it, but I still enjoy taking it out for a blast. Some of the things the purists won't like we've done, but you know, we've got the bike how we want to use the bike. We do quite a few miles. We go to the Alps, we go to Scotland, we ride in all sorts of weathers, and we take luggage. So I'll just run through a few of the items anyway. I mean, the first one, the most obvious here, we've hardwired in a Garmin 660 sat nav. Fits in quite well there. I'll show you. Clips on there. You still see the clocks okay, still get to the key okay. I mean, that is a triumph item there, the bracket that bolts onto the top yoke there. So wired into the ignition, so it comes on with the ignition. Great bit of kit. I highly recommend those because you can program in your routes. I prefer them over the TomTom, but that's just me. She's also gone for the Triumph heated grips. They work okay, quite neat, although you think where your hand is, you want to put them on. It isn't exactly, Triumph. I mean, talk about a last minute thought where the button was going to go. It's pretty rubbish. I think the newer 765, hopefully they've done a better job of integrating the electrics. But anyway, they work okay. Not as good as Oxford. They work on two stages. They're either hot, they're either warm or lukewarm. But it worked okay and it looked quite nice. It's certainly better than nothing. You'll see here there's the tank ring. We use that for two different tank bags that we've got. I'll show you. If you're just going out for a day's run, we use this small one, and I'll show you how that fits on. That's the day pack. Sorry, it's looking a bit tatty, but it's a few years old now. Got the same mechanism on underneath that they all have, which clamps around there. Just snaps on. You know, it's great for a day. You know, you've not got to have all your crap in your pockets. You can just have it there, get your purse and whatever, wallet. Or if we're going on a bigger trip, this does fit. She had it on her old Street Triple. It does just fit with the sat nav. It's tight, but still fits the tank quite well. That's the sport version. God knows why they call it sport, but again, it's like all the other SW Motec tank bags. It's got the pockets both sides. It does raise and come up. This one's got a handy mat pocket at the top. So nice bit of kit. Like I say, this one's now 4 years old, still going great guns. There's a waterproof over cover if you're riding in the pouring rain. I mean, it's reasonably showerproof as it is, but you want to put the cover on if it's chucking it down. Easily removed, you just pull that, lifts off. Alright, the other thing that helps us go touring is the SW Motec Blaze pannier system. And underneath here, I'll probably see from this side better, there's some brackets bolted onto the rear foot pegs. That, there, that, and that brace. they all allow those brackets, and those brackets remain on the bike, and they allow these things to plug in when you want to go touring. So snap in there like that. That one snaps in the other side. And you can see how well worn these are. Like I say, they're 2012, but they still work well. We had them on the old street. We had to have a different bracket because that had got the high up exhaust on. So we got different legs, but it's the same. It's the same bags. These just click in like that. Same that side. Click in there. There's Velcro. Comes over there. Now, I was slightly concerned whether it might mark the paintwork. So far it hasn't. If we're going on a long trip, we'll sometimes put a sticking plaster just over that in that inside corner there, so it doesn't mark the paintwork. But basically those bags let you get quite a lot on, and they also expand out like that. Do that both sides, so you can get quite a bit in there. Top loaders, and inside there's a waterproof roll top bag that goes inside. You've put your clothes in there, you roll the top up, fasten it, and your stuff stays dry. Well, that's the plan anyway. Obviously the only downside of that is all these do get wet and they get quite sludgy. You know, if you're arriving at your hotel after a long ride, you've got to take those bags in the hotel. And if they're dripping with mud, it's not ideal, but for me, it's still nicer than spoiling the look of your bike by having a load of hard frames on the back. I mean, you do what you like to do to your bike, but we don't like hard frames, so we only tour a few times a year, so we prefer to have this system on. That's when it's off, it returns the bike to something like standard. Now I'm sure some of you will have noticed and thought, what is that? That actually is a Triumph part. It mounts straight over the existing OE number plate mount, and what it does, and we can see what it does really, it stops you getting absolutely covered in crud when you're riding this bike with wet roads. The first time my wife rode this bike, we rode it home from the dealer, it was a wet day, she got a new riding kit on and just completely splattered in mud, right up her back, right over her helmet, and she wasn't best pleased. So I made a few inquiries, and in some countries that is fitted as a standard item. Jack Lilly got that for me actually, and it's not too bad a job. You just undo it, take that apart, that slides over, just put it back together again. I mean, a lot of guys do the opposite, don't they? They take that off altogether, shorten it and put a tail tidy on. For me, if you're riding this bike in damp weather, you don't want to get absolutely covered in road dirt, that is a solution. And the shorter you make that, and the more you put your tail tidy under there and your number plate under there, the more you're going to get covered in road filth. So, guys, if you're only riding in the dry that's fair enough, but you know, we choose to ride in lots of weather conditions, so that's the route we've gone. Normally, when she's not got the panniers on and the pannier system on, that sits on the back, bolts on under the seat. So that's what the bike looks like most of the time. The other issue we've had with this bike, especially compared to the older model, first gear is really tall, and the missus found, you know, sort of really tight nadgery bends quite difficult because she's all the while having to slip the clutch to manoeuvre around. So we recently took the decision to go one tooth down. Got a Renthal, we've gone to I think it's 15 tooth. But anyway, we've gone one tooth down from stock, and we've yet to really try it out yet to see what sort of difference it is. I mean, I rode it back from the dealer, and it definitely, you know, it definitely gave the you know, a shorter first gear. Probably give you a punchier acceleration as well. So hopefully she'll like that modification. Obviously, if you're sitting on dual carriageways a long time or motorways, it's raised the revs in sixth, probably taking it up around about eight, you know, if you're doing just above motorway speeds, but it's still perfectly acceptable. That's about it, really. I mean, as far as the touring stuff, when we're doing a really big trip, we've got the panniers on, we've got the tank bag on both of the bikes, we use this overboard waterproof luggage and basically strap it onto the panniers. And I'll tell you what are really good. Rock straps, in my opinion, way better than bungees. They've got some stretch in them, but they've not got the metal ends on them. You just pass them through and pull them tight, and they've got your gear on really well. I highly recommend them. So that's about it. That's all we've done. I mean, it's the second one of these that she's owned. She loves it, and she's been to look at the RS765. Looks a terrific bike. So very tempting. That comes, the RS comes, you know, the new RS comes with one of those, a standard, which is the quick shifter, and that on this bike, terrific bit of kit, absolutely lovely to use, and it works flawlessly, no issues whatsoever. You just tap it through the gearbox and it's just lovely. So that's it, that concludes really, you know, everything I've got to say. So right, catch up with you next time. Cheers.